Alright, YouTube, so I'm back again with another video about another analysis that I wanted to make. I know I brought this issue up a couple times before, but it's been on my mind a little bit because I've talked to a few people about this issue. Some people agree, some don't. Some don't really know what to think on this issue because they don't really care one way or another about it. Possibly because it's in Brazil and it doesn't really, it's not their country, not anything that has to do with them. But the reason that it interests me in particular is because I've done a lot of, studying on the whole, Latin America, Caribbean region over the past several years. Just about U.S. imperialism in Latin America and the Caribbean and why I think it's fucked up and how our country has backed brutal dictators like Pinochet in Chile and the Brazilian military dictatorship, and you got all these like right-wing dictators that that the U.S. propped back in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, and in the 50s too. Coups in various regions, and let's not forget Batista in Cuba, and just shit like that. So now we've got another brutal regime that's taking place in Latin America. Jair Bolsonaro, I think I'm pronouncing his name correctly. Jair Bolsonaro in Brazil. And my whole thing is, I was just talking about the reason, and one of the reasons I wanted to discuss this today is because I was kind of, just talking about it with a few people, online and offline too. But I thought I wanted to just figure I'd just get my thoughts on this, and just to bring up the point about how bad this guy is, and just how bad he is for, just not just for politics in Brazil, but also just bad for the world too, because, he's a threat to the Amazon. He's a climate change denier. He wants to deforest the Amazon rainforest. The Amazon rainforest went up in flames back in 2019. His foreign minister says that climate change is a fucking Marxist plot and all this other fucking crazy shit like that. So yeah, like Bolsonaro and his regime is as crazy as it gets. And now, he's undoubtedly a fascist. There's no question in my mind about that. And one of the things I wanted to discuss today is how Brazil can defeat this bad leader. Now, like I said, the reason that Bolsonaro got in the first place is because, I think a lot of Brazilians were tired of the corrupt leaders that were in power. They were tired of these leaders for like a long time that were just too far left, and Brazilians were willing to try something different, because I think that they, just with their system of government, based on what I've read and from who I've talked to, they've just said that they've just been beat down and all that. They're just sick and tired of the corruption, their rising crime, their politicians are too weak on crime and all that. But Lula da Silva in Brazil was a really successful leader. Some say he had his forms of corruption too, and I'm pretty sure, and I don't deny that, I don't doubt that for a second. Dilma Rousseff got in after she was impeached because she was corrupt. Then her vice president was also just this wishy-washy neoliberal. His approval rating plummeted to almost zero. And then that, because he was corrupt, he was found guilty on corruption charges. And then that paved the way for Bolsonaro to get in and all these right-wing populists to get in. But, so now Bolsonaro has proven to be just a complete mess, and just, he's just corrupt also. He's got his own share of corruption, and he's just a complete bigot, and I've read off, the other day when I made that video, maybe about a week and a half ago or whatever, about how, his most bigoted quotes and all that, like, the most offensive things that he said, and how he's just a complete bigot, and maybe a flat-out racist in some cases. And I don't just throw around the word bigot or racist, but based on what I've read about Bolsonaro, he is a bigot. He's a complete homophobe. He's completely and utterly homophobic. And he's just every bad thing that you can imagine. So how can Brazil defeat this man? The way you can defeat Bolsonaro, you need to have somebody out there that is willing to put the kibosh on this extremism from both sides. You cannot have like a far left leader in Brazil either. They can't win either, because they're going to be piss weak on crime. They're not going to do well when it comes to the issue of punishing criminals and giving them the punishments that they deserve. They're going to be weak on crime and all that, and probably corrupt too, put money in their pockets. You know, there's just going to be a lot of shit with that too. But in order to defeat Bolsonaro, you either need a moderate liberal, like, you know, like when I say moderate liberal, I mean someone who's like center left, someone who stands for freedom, stands for liberal principles, someone who stands for just freedom in general, but also is not too far to the left either, is also going to take the issue of crime more seriously, and is not going to be as corrupt. Or you need a moderate conservative that, you know, appeals to the moderate, you know, appeals to, like, more people who have more traditional beliefs, who will also, you know, believe in the principles of freedom and everything else. That's who you need. Someone who has more traditional views. But when I say traditional views, I just mean someone who, you know, not like a born-again Christian or an extreme evangelical like Bolsonaro. You need someone who is moderately conservative, maybe center-right or something like that. But you cannot put a wishy-washy neoliberal hack or a far, far, far leftist up against Bolsonaro. They can't win. Now, if you put up somebody like a strong liberal up against Bolsonaro, like Lula, they would absolutely crush Bolsonaro. In 2018, if Lula da Silva ran against Bolsonaro, Bolsonaro would have gotten absolutely crushed by Lula, because Lula was a very successful leader, lifted millions of people out of poverty in Brazil. He put the kibosh on a lot of, you know, corrupt things. He built social programs for the poor and all that. So it proved to be very successful in a number of cases. It proved to be very successful. Now, if you put that leader up against Bolsonaro would have had no chance. He would have been fucking toast. He would have been destroyed. But the reason Bolsonaro steamrolled the other side was because the other side was too far to the left and was just a neoliberal and just wishy-washy. And they were sick and tired of Michael Temer and Dilma Rousseff and all their corrupt bargains. Dilma Rousseff tried to continue Lula's policies, but she proved to be a dud. And she was just corrupt in her own ways. And just shit like that happened. So that paved the way for these other leaders. So, like, but, you know, like, what is Bolsonaro doing? Like, Bolsonaro is not doing anything for the poor. He's not doing anything to solve crime. All he's doing is he's just talking about social issues. He's just talking about social issues. He's an extreme right-wing evangelical conservative who wants to get in other people's bedrooms, who wants to get involved in gay people's bedrooms and get involved in other people's business. It's just not going to work. Like, having an extreme right-wing fascist in power is not working. A climate change denier and everything else. If you put up a moderate liberal who believes in liberal principles, Bolsonaro will get fucking destroyed in 2023. Mark my words. But if you put up someone who's a neoliberal corporatist or someone that is too far, far to the left, then Bolsonaro is going to win re-election again. That's what I'm going to say. So Bolsonaro is not doing anything to help anything. Like, he's mismanaged the coronavirus there. He's done all sorts of fucked up shit. He's made all kinds of bigoted comments about women, gays, and indigenous people, blacks, and just everybody else. So other minorities and everything else. And that's all Bolsonaro has done, and destroying the Amazon rainforest in the process, and pandering under the table to other evangelicals and to other evangelicals in Brazil and other corrupt officials. You know, it's fucked up. I mean, politics in the world is fucked up, and that's why I try to stay away from this type of topic. But the reason I wanted to discuss this today is because it's been on my mind, because I've studied a lot of that stuff in that region, and it's fucked up. This is just another recreation of the Pinochet years in Brazil in reverse, essentially. It's not good. It's not pretty. It's not going to be good if you keep people like this in power. Neither is it going to be if you have a far, far, far leftist in power either. Because that's not going to be successful either. Because that's going to pave the way for extreme right-wing authoritarians like Bolsonaro. People can say, Nicolas Maduro is a socialist dictator, blah, blah, blah. That might be true. And there's no doubt in my mind that he is also a fuck-up for Venezuela. And there's other leaders in the region that are too far left and are also authoritarian, which I don't support either. I don't support those leaders either. Now, I'm center-left, but I don't support those leaders either. Why? Because they're authoritarian. I don't support authoritarians, whether on the left or on the right. Come on now. But all Bolsonaro is doing, I mean, you gotta be fucking kidding me, Bolsonaro. I mean, all Bolsonaro is doing is just bitching about the left. Bolsonaro and his minions are just bitching about how, the left is bad and everything else. And like, the left wing in Brazil is the worst thing that's happened to Brazil in the last 1,000 years. You know, he's basically saying the same thing that the American evangelicals in this country are saying. Like they said about Obama. Like Rick Santorum was bitching about Obama constantly. And others were bitching about Obama. Like, Obama's the worst president in 1,000 years or 100 years or whatever. Saying, bitching about this. Rick Santorum, Newt Gingrich, Marco Rubio, Ted Cruz, Trump. All these Republicans were bitching and doing the same thing that Bolsonaro's doing in Brazil. Just bitching about the other side without having an alternative. But bitching about the other side only helps your case if you have a good alternative. Bitching about the other side is not going to benefit your side unless you have an alternative. Bolsonaro is not the alternative to the problem. He is not the solution to the problem. He is part of the problem. So if you want to defeat Bolsonaro, you need someone who is more moderate. You need someone who is also not too extreme either way. Because if you have someone that's too extreme to the left, they're not going to win. But if you put someone up that's more, you know, moderate and also believes in the principle of freedom, then they're going to destroy Bolsonaro. Bolsonaro will be done. So, and I don't think Joe Biden is supporting Bolsonaro like Trump did. So I think Bolsonaro he's going to fall through the table. His regime is probably going to collapse eventually. I don't know. I don't know what the fuck's going to happen. But all I can say is that let's just hope that Brazil can defeat this guy, because this guy is not good. Bolsonaro is not good. Bolsonaro is a complete bigot and a warmonger and a tyrant. He's a right-wing authoritarian, and he's not good either. He's no better than any of the left-wing authoritarians in Latin America either. I'm not saying that they're not fucked up either. They are. They're fucked up too. But Bolsonaro is not an alternative to them. Are you kidding me? So, that's all I gotta say about it. So, just defeat Bolsonaro, but also defeat the far left, because the far left is no good either. You can't be too extreme on either the left or the right. They can't win. And people are going to go to the other side because the other side believes in free market and other in this and that. They believe in smaller government. People aren't going to dish higher taxes, more government, and all that other stuff. It's not going to happen. It's just not going to happen. They can't win. That's not to say that Bolsonaro doesn't believe in big government, because he does. He wants the government to get involved in people's bedrooms. He wants the government to deforest the Amazon rainforest, and he wants to use the government to persecute his political opponents. So Bolsonaro was extreme in his own way. That's all I gotta say. So that's all I gotta say for today. I'm probably not gonna cover Bolsonaro that much anymore at this point, unless I have something else. So all I want to say is that's the solution. So if people want to defeat Bolsonaro, then what you need to do is you need to get someone more moderate in there. Because otherwise, Bolsonaro is going to win again, and it's probably not going to be a good path for Brazil. If Bolsonaro continues on the path that he's going on, Brazil's democracy is going to be in jeopardy. It's already in jeopardy. Because Bolsonaro would not... He wants to bring back Brazil's military dictatorship that they had back in the 60s, that the U.S. backed for our corporate interests back in the 60s and 70s and all that, until Brazil returned to democracy, and then Lula paved the way for that. So I'm not a staunch Lula supporter either. I mean, I'm sure Lula had his fair share of corruption. I don't know about the whole Operation Car Wash thing. I'm sure there's a lot of things in that too. If anyone from Brazil or elsewhere who's more familiar on the whole Operation Car Wash, well, I mean, I've read some things about it, but I haven't gotten too much into it. I haven't dove too much into detail about it. I am familiar with the situation, but it's just, it's all fucked up, people. Politics is a mess. That's why I kind of try to stay away from it. I only talk about it every now and again on this channel when it's something that I feel passionate to talk about. But other than that, I try to stay away from it. And I'm probably going to stay away from it for the foreseeable future. At least until Bolsonaro does something monumentally fucked up, or he gets reelected, or hopefully some more moderate, level-minded person in Brazil wins. Let's just hope for the latter. Anyway, I'm going to cut it here because I'm going to go, got other things to do today. But I just wanted to take the time to make this. I'm about to head to my friend's house now, so I just wanted to make this video while, beforehand, and got a lot of stuff going on next week. So probably not going to upload for about a week or so, because I got other stuff going on. Next week, so I'll get more into that. I hope everyone's doing well out there, and I hope welcome to all the new subscribers that have subscribed recently. Comment, subscribe, let me know what you think. Do you agree with me on my position on Bolsonaro? Do you disagree? But let me know what you think either way. And either way, comment, let me know what you think. And I'll be back with more videos soon. This is Zach the Celtics Guy. Thank you for watching. And I'll be back with more videos and a whole bunch of stuff in the works. Stay tuned. Bye for now. Peace out. Have a good day.